A lonely wave is beating on the rocky Antrim shore, and the sighing winds are a-keening o'er the water's solemn roar. The seabirds sweep to heaven with a loud and piercing wail. 'Tis the passing knell of one who dies in a lonely English jail. Along the sweltering Congo swamps, a ghastly silence falls, and the jungle trees hang lifeless like a thousand funeral palls. And dark-skinned men are heavy with a fear they cannot name, while their gentle friend is led to death with mockery and shame. A lordly Roger Casement, you gave all a man could give, that justice be not mocked at, and that liberty might live. But you hurt the high and the mighty ones in pocket and in pride, and that is why they hated you, and that is why you died. They stripped you of your manners and they hounded you to death, and their bloodlust was not sated when you gasped your dying breath. They tried to foul your memory as they fouled your corpse with lime, but God is not an Englishman, and truth will tell with time. Ah, gentle Roger Casement, you have blessed us in your death. They have tried to blot you from our minds, but we will not forget. Your cause will be triumphant, and when slavery's night is o'er, your bones shall rest, your last request, on the rocky Murlock shore. A heavy soldier dies, body thin and weak with hunger, as the light fades from his eyes. By his side, two women weeping, one is old and one is young, on their knees to God appealing, their soft, sweet Mayo tongue. Ah, my loves, the young man murmurs, do not cry your tears for me, for my time is nearly over, and today I will be free. I can see a bright sun shining on my own green Mayo fields, and I see dear Michael Gawen waiting there beneath the trees. In that cruel British prison, just before the break of day, with his loved ones there beside him, a young soldier passed away. But he lives in Erwin's heart yet, and wherever flies her fly, Ireland's sons and Ireland's daughters will remember brave Frank Stye. But he lives in Erin's heart yet, and wherever flies her fly, Ireland's sons and Ireland's daughters will remember brave Frank Stye.
Laws are made for people, and the law can never scorn the right of a man to be free.
We the people, let them have a say. We the people, let them see the light of day. The dismal dawn was breaking as they took a man away. Not knowing what was his crime, just what he was guilty of, not one of them could say. But they'll think of something in time. He says goodbye and remember, we shall overcome. People, let them have a say. We the people, let them see the light of day. Comforting her children, crying softly in the night, she tries very hard to explain. You know your daddy never did a thing that wasn't right, so soon he's bound to be home again. He is a good man, and he shall overcome. We the people, let them have a say. Let them see the light of day.
What does it profit a man the right to be born if he suffers the loss of his liberty? Laws are made for people, and the law can never scorn the right of a man to be free. We are the people, and we shall overcome.
And we shall overcome. We the people, let them have a say. We the people, let them see the light of day. We the people, have a say. We the people, let them see the light of day.
Are filled with sorrow and with sadness. Many hearts are filled with anguish and with pain. For old Ireland now she hangs her head in mourning. For the man who fell at Upton for Sinn Féin. Let the moon shine out tonight along the valley, where those lads who fought
fought for freedom now are laid. May they rest in peace, those men who died for Ireland and who fell at all in ambush for Sinn Féin. Some were thinking of their mothers, wives and sweethearts. More were thinking of their dear old Irish homes. Did they think of how they drilled along the valley when they marched out from Cork City to their doom? Let the moon shine out tonight along the valley, where those lads who fought for freedom now are laid. May they rest in peace, those men who died for Ireland and who fell at all in ambush for Sinn Féin. The morning cry rang out, fix your bayonets, and right gallantly they fixed them for the fray. Gallantly they fought and died for dear old Ireland, round the lonely woods at Upton far away. Let the moon shine out tonight along the valley, where those lads who fought for freedom now are laid. May they rest in peace, those men who died for Ireland and who fell at Upton ambush for Sinn Féin.
High upon the gallows tree swung the noble heart of three, by the vengeful Karen stricken in the bloom. But they met him face to face with the courage of the race, and they won with souls undaunted to their doom. God save Ireland, cried the heroes. God save Ireland, cried the old. Whether on the scaffold high or the battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for Ireland dear we fall? Girt around with cruel foes, still their courage proudly rose, for they thought of hearts that loved them far and near. Oh, the millions true and brave, o'er the ocean's swelling wave, and the friends in holy Ireland ever dear. God save Ireland, cried the heroes. God save Ireland, cried they all. Whether on the scaffold high or the battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for Ireland dear we fall? Climb they up the rugged stair, find their voices out in prayer, then with England's fatal cord around them cast, close beside the gallows tree, kiss like brothers lovingly, true to home and faith and freedom to the last. God save Ireland, cried the heroes. God save Ireland, cried they all. Whether on the scaffold high or the battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for Ireland here we fall? Never till
that latest day shall the memory pass away of the gallant lives thus given for our land. Ah, but on the cause must go, amid joy or weal or woe, till we make this island nation free and grand.
God save Ireland, cried the heroes. God save Ireland, cried they all. Whether on the scaffold high or the battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for Ireland here we fall?
Father, why are you so sad on this bright Easter morn? When Irishmen are proud and glad of a land where they were born. A son I see in memory's view, afar off distant day. When being just a boy like you, I joined the IRA. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, probably I long to see the boys of the old brigade. From hill and farm the call to arms was heard by one and all, and from the glen came brave young men to answer Ireland's call. It was long ago we faced the foe, the old brigade and me, and by my side they fought and died that Ireland might be free. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, Ramapree, I long to see the boys of the old brigade. And now, my son, I've told you why on Easter morn I sigh. For I recall my comrades all from dark old days gone by. I think of men who fought in glen with a rifle and grenade. May heaven keep the men who sleep from the ranks of the old brigade. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, Ramapree, I long to see the boys of the old brigade. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, Ramapree, I long to see the boys of the old brigade.
The struggle is over, the boys are defeated. Old Ireland surrounded with sadness and gloom. We were defeated and shamefully treated. And I, Robert Emmet, awaiting my doom. Hung, drawn and quartered, sure that was my sentence, but soon I will show them
no coward am I. My crime is the love of the land I was born in, a hero I lived and a hero I'll die. Oh, Robert Emmett, the darling of Erin. Oh, Robert Emmett will die with a smile. Farewell, companions, both loyal and daring. I lay down my life for the Emerald Isle. Hark the bells tolling, I well know its meaning. My poor heart it tells me it is my death knell. In come the clergy, the warder is leading. I have no friends here to bid me farewell. Goodbye, old Ireland, my parents and sweetheart, companions in arms, to forget you must try. I'm proud of me other, it was only my duty, a hero I live and a hero I'll die. Oh, Robert Emmett, the darling of Erin. Oh, Robert Emmett, will die with a smile. Farewell, companions, both loyal and daring. I lay down my life for the Emerald Isle.
At Easter time, 1916, when flowers bloomed and trees were green, there dawned a day when freedom's cry called out brave men to fight and die. They were the men with the vision, the men with the cause, the men who defied their oppressors' laws, the men who traded their chains for guns. Born into slavery, they were freedom's sons. In Dublin town, they fought and died, with Pierce, McDermott and McBride, ourselves alone. Cry and freedom sang to the Easter sky. They were the men with the vision, the men with the cause, the men who defied their oppressors' laws, the men who traded their chains for guns. Born into slavery, they were freedom's sons. A poet's dream had sparked the flame, a raging fire that soon became
that is. There rose a nation proud and free. They were the man with the vision, the man with the cause, the man who defied the oppressor's laws, the man who traded their chains for guns. Born into slavery, they were freedom's sons. Six counties are in bondage still. Those men who died, was this their will? Until they're free and oppression cease, only then can they rest in peace. They were the men with the vision, the men with the cause, the men who defied their oppressors' laws, the men who traded their chains for guns. Born to slavery, they were freedom's
sons. Morn was breaking over Dublin's weary town. 16 brave men have fallen to the rifles of the crown. Because they loved their country and served night and day. But before they faced the rifles, this is what boys did say.
Take away the blood-stained bandage from off an Irish brow. We fought and bled for Ireland, and we will not shirk it now. We have held her in her struggle, in an answer to her call. And because we sought to free her, we are placed against the wall.
Ned Daly, Houston, Colbert, MacDonough and MacBride, MacDermott and the brothers Kent, with Clark and Plunkett died. McMahon, Pat and Lee Pierce, Mohan, Mahan, and Kien. And the last of all, James Connolly, this message to them send.
Take away the blood-stained bandage from off an Irish brow. We fought and bled for Ireland, and we will not shirk it now. We upheld her in her struggle, in answer to her call. And because we sought to free her, we are placed against the wall. Take away the blood-stained bandage from off an Irish brow. We fought and bled for Ireland, and it now. We upheld her in her struggle, in answer to her call. And because we sought to free her, we are placed against the wall.
Thank you.
flag of Ireland, boys, let our east breezes blow. Around it flows wherever it flies, defiance to the foe. Let no man weep where true men fought to make their country free. The flag that James Connolly loved is good enough for me. Give me the flag of Munster, boys, to victory lead us on. Of Rebel Park, of Kerry, boys, and Clare and Gerry on. Tell them in Tipperary town the North will yet be free. The flag that Munster heroes love is good enough for me. Give me the flag of Connacht, boys, and westward let her flow. To meet the flying columns that from Longford town did go. God keep you, ancient Galway, let your sons have victory. The flag that volunteers did love is good enough for me. Give me the flag of Ulster, boys, it's Ireland's flag also. We love them yet, and we won't forget Red Hugh and Owen Roe. For still there breathes on Irish soil the soul of liberty. The flag that Ireland's martyrs love is good enough for me. The flag that Ireland's martyrs love is good enough for me. The summer sun was sinking low behind the western sea. The lark's loud song was pealing sweet, but it brought no joy to me. For the one I loved is far away, he left his starving's den. He fought till death and then he left the woodlands of Loughlin. A noble Irish man was he, John Bergen was his name. He belonged to Tipperary and from Nina town he came. But now, thank God that he is gone, he is free from harm and sin. And he let them have his parting shot in the woodlands of Loughlin. MacDermot too was brave and true from the plains of Ballinagar. He is missed from many a fireside, from the homes both near and far. He is missed at home in Bracloon by his own dear kith and kin, and his comrades true shall miss him too in the woodlands of Loughlin. Young Bergen said that he was proud to die for Ireland's cause. The deed was done that should be done against England's cruel laws. He said goodbye to Tipperary town and to every dale and glen, and to all my faithful comrades in the woodlands of Loughlin. Take this message to our own brave boys and tell them we are dead. Tell them to be of utmost cheer and to hold no drooping head, to keep old brains a-using, to fight and not give in, and be proud to die 'neath an airy sky in the woodlands of Loughlin.
I dreamt I saw you last night, alive as you and me. Says I to Joe, you're 10 years dead. I never died, said he. I never died, said he. The copper bosses killed you, Joe. They pumped you full of lead. Takes more than guns to kill a man, said Joe, and I ain't dead. Said Joe, and I ain't dead. And standing there as large as life, smiling with his eyes, said Joe, what they forgot to kill, we're going to organize. We're going to organize. In Salt Lake City, you and I stood there side by side. The framed you on a murder charge, said Joe, I never died. Said Joe, I never died. From San Diego up to Maine, and every mine and mill, we're working men defend their rights. That's where you'll find Joe Hill. That's where you'll find Joe Hill. I dreamt I saw Joe last night, alive as you and me. Says I to Joe, you're 10 years dead. I never died, said he. I never died, said he.